The president doesn't want the public to see the underlying facts. What is revealed in our memo are quotations from the very FISA application that really demonstrate just how misleading the Republicans have been. Their goal here is to put the FBI on trial, to put Bob Mueller's investigation on trial, and the president is only too happy to accommodate.
Determined to have their counter memo released, Congressman Adam Schiff, the top-ranking Democrat on House Intel, says he'll meet with the FBI once again. They'll review the contents of the Democrats' memo and decide what needs to be redacted for national security purposes. As our own Julia Ainslie just noted, last week the White House Counsel's Office said the president was unable to release the memo at this time because of classified information. The White House Director of Legislative Affairs, their chief lobbyist on the Hill, elaborated this morning on Fox News.
The reality is that the White House is going to look forward to releasing that memo. What we've heard from the intelligence community is there are sources and methods in the Democrat memo that they do not want revealed. So the president simply said, I'm going to send it back to the House Democrats, ask them to clean it up.
So with us from Chicago, Illinois Democratic Congressman Mike Quigley, importantly a member of the House Intel Committee. And Congressman, for folks who've been watching the Olympics and the half pipe and curling perhaps and veering into and out of news on any given day, remind our audience, in your view, why is it important to get this memo out and how is what's in it going to reach above the din?
Yeah, it's a fair question, but let's just put it in perspective. The president immediately and with almost no scrutiny releases a memo that he says vindicates him. And that memo, if you follow my questioning in these open hearings, I think shows that this memo was put together in conjunction or in coordination with the White House and the Republicans on the Intel Committee, a memo that the Justice Department said was dangerously reckless. And the FBI said had grave concerns about its accuracy. So when our memo comes down the pike, it's a whole different story, a memo that I believe would bolster the integrity of the investigation and the intelligence community. It's a different story. Look, the Republicans can get away with this. They have the votes. The question is, are they willing to help suppress this investigation? Are they willing to help the president of the United States obstruct what we're trying to do?
Well, they return the favor to you guys and say your memo is hardly pure as the driven snow, that it was loaded with sources and methods creating an intentional political football and making redaction necessary.
Yeah, I think the first memo launched this. I think the only thing worse than releasing the first memo is releasing the first memo without the second. As Adam Schiff has suggested, we are more than willing to work with the Justice Department and the FBI to go over those redactions, to move this forward so we don't reveal sources and methods. It's hard to undo the damage they've done, not just to the integrity of the investigation, but the trust and the relationship between Congress and these intel agencies. That's going to take a long time to repair. So we're willing to work with justice. The White House was not. The Republicans on the Intel Committee voted against us when we asked that this be reviewed before it was released. It was only done on a cursory basis. The Justice Department also asked, before it was released, to be able to come address the entire body of Congress in an executive session to discuss their concerns about its accuracy and about its attacks on sources and methods. The Republicans refuse to accept that vote as well.
Well, let me ask you something else on behalf of taxpayers everywhere. We're paying the tab for the House Intel Committee. Everyone we have on this broadcast says it's beyond toxic, and the committee itself is broken, which is a little scary considering it's one of our repositories, ideally, of our nation's secrets. We entrust that to you members of the committee. Why are we continuing something called House Intel if it's this broken?
Because it does extraordinarily important work to keep our country safe. I served in that committee for 2 years before the Trump administration. And again, we didn't have these problems. It got broke when Devin Nunes decided that he was going to be an agent of the White House and not an independent investigator. When they decide to invest in what can only be described as an autocratic president, And by that, I mean a president who believes he is above the law. This isn't the first time they've done that with this memo. Believe us, we'd love to have attack back to the original investigation. We're hardly done. We haven't scratched things like money laundering. Devin Nunes has refused subpoenas on key witnesses. He's gone along with the White House on gag orders. He started rogue unilateral investigations. It wasn't like this before. The common theme is this began when they decided to help the president of the United States stop this investigation.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.